Facebook Nation, walk it like I talk it. Who will emerge today as the next asphalt god? You are watching the Slam Summer Classic, the first ever, the inaugural Slam Summer Classic, live from Dyckman Park. I'm the voice, Bobby C. That's my partner in crime, Uncle G Stacks, and we are ready for the showdown of showdowns. Now, you've seen six showdowns, but there is not a showdown like this one, and I'll tell you why, folks, because it's not just one guest star, it's 20 of the best players in the country. Uncle G Stacks, put it into context for us. Tell us about Dyckman Park, because it's not a night game tonight, of course. It's a day game, but it's still Dyckman Park.
Before we even begin, it's just the hype, it's just the moment, and there's a couple of things we just gotta go out. We're talking about Facebook Live, we're talking about Sam, Dyckman, New York City, following the whole thing to this point. We heard about the numbers, we're impressed, and the love for you guys is crazy. We really, really appreciate that. My production family back in Texas, my production family here, downtown, the whole Slam family, Bobby C, Uncle G, we had to take a moment and thank you guys. Now, when you get to the live action, when you talk about a day like today, I think for an announcer, it's almost like a bucket list. You know, I think it's a chance.
Like an NBA final.
I think it's a chance to talk to your kids. I think it's a chance to tell people, yo, I was there when they broke so-and-so in. So coming out and getting Bobby C, getting Uncle G, getting Dyckman Park, shout to Kenny Steve. It's just a magical moment. And me, I'm just honored. I'm just truly overwhelmed.
And folks, we are wrapping up the girls' game right now, which has really been great as well. A lot of talent in this game. And you can just kind of feel the juice already in the park for the matchup. People were lined up early trying to get in. People still lined up trying to get in. And there's no space to sit. Again, crammed here at Dyckman Park for this big event. And G-Stacks, very interesting lineups here. And I think the way Slam has done it, and Facebook too, amazing how they have actually set up this game. So you have Team Ramsey taking on Team Stanley. Ramsey today will be playing in the black. Stanley will be playing in the white. And again, for those kind of engaging us on social media, you got a chance to see, looking at Slam, last night they moved the action indoors to Lifetime Athletic at Sky on the west side. Now, that might be familiar to some, because those that watch the NBA, they watch a lot of these kind of preseason pickup games where you see guys like Carmelo Anthony and LeBron James, and they're down at Lifetime. They're playing, they're getting the games in. But last night, we turned that place upside down, folks. We had the dunk contest, and we had a one-on-one contest. And you know what? The winners of those two contests are the captains for today's game.
Appropriately.
And appropriately, right? So, G, we get the captains. Last night, we do it up even better than this, because we actually take the guys out on the Hudson on a boat to pick the teams. That's right. If you were checking this out on the gram, you could see it. We take them out on the Hudson. You got, again, Ramsey and Stanley as the captains, and they divide these two incredible rosters. And you know, G, it was really cool for me, because you know, you get a chance to see the guys trying to rep where they're from. So this game's going to have a lot of both local feel and national feel. You'll get a chance to see really pretty much New York versus California, which leads us into our first poll question, because we want to know where you're watching the game from today. That's a question that we love to open up every broadcast with. Where are you watching the game? We know we're here at Dyckman. You really don't even have to be at Dyckman, because there's no place to sit anyway. So you can be here today with us through the stream, which is awesome. And again, where you're watching the game from today, just type it in the comments. We want the full answer so we know where you're watching the game from. G-Stacks, I'm just so pumped for this game.
And it's been incredible. Like, when you talk about the Facebook Live Nation and the support and where these people have called in from, you know, you talk Philippines, Australia, California. It's been national. It's been global. So it's engaged. And today, I think it's no different. I think the Facebook needs to be out in full force. As you can see, they lined up all over the park. And again, another magic moment at the epic center of the streets, man. And that's what's up. And it's a real, real shout to Slam for bringing out Bobby C and Uncle G. DJ Zookeeper as well.
Now, the players from New York are Deshaun Davis, Andre Jackson, Jalen Lecque, Joe Toussaint, and Zachary Fremantle. And then you got a couple guys, again, big stars from California, Cassius Stanley, Josh Christopher, Jalen Green. And the first thing that Cassius said to me last night after the teams were drafted was, we got all the West Coast guys, man. We're going to win this game. So you get that sense of pride coming into this, that the guys want to run New York, but the West Coast family is trying to come here today and invade the park. And Cassius Stanley making some big moves in the draft early on. He took those guys, like we said, you had Christopher and Green early picks, but he's also got Jaden McDaniels. He's got Kyree Walkers from out there as well right now playing at Hillcrest. Zion Harmon, Terrence Clark, and got one New York guy too, the last pick in the draft. Pretty good last pick in the draft. 50 points last season at the high school level, Joseph Girard III.
Wow.
On the flip side, yeah, I mean, Ramsey's got R.J. Hampton, Sharife Cooper, Noah Farrakhan, Deshaun Davis, Joe Toussaint, James Wiseman. I mean, think of all of these names. Andre Jackson, Precious Achiuwa. I mean, amazing lineups here, G. I just, you know, I don't even know if we're going to have enough time to talk about everybody, to be honest with you. I mean, this is, again, not just really one or two main stars, but you have both loaded rosters, and they can only start five guys, right?
It's the treat. You know, I think it's the fans. I think it's the support that they've had. And I think what Slammers went and did, and as you saw yesterday on the yacht thing, Dave went out and just got the best of the best. They've got the cream of the crop for the fans. They know this is the last licks. They know after this is school, it's back to chasing careers. What better way than to send off the best fans anywhere than a game like this with huge talent from all across the nation?
You know, and G, it was very cool because when they put all the guys on the Royal Princess, that's the name of the boat,
wow,
they took a photo, which also went on social media, which I think is a really big part of the world today, right?
You gotta believe it.
I was talking to Kyree Walker's dad, and he said, you know what, Bobby? There's a lot of money in that picture right there.
Wow.
Because this is the future of the NBA. You're getting a chance to see it live here today on the stream. Uncle G Stacks and Bobby C calling out the first ever Slam Summer Classic. 20 of the best high school players in the land trying to run the NYC. The concrete jungle, as I like to call it. And again, we talked about it right as we kicked open the show. Who will be the next asphalt god? Who will be the next playground legend? You'll get a chance to see today who can emerge, who can rise. Facebook Nation, we're happy to have you with us. I mean, Cassius Stanley, the dunk champ last night, but think about the schools, the recruitment that comes into this. Last season, he averaged 19 a game, 5 assists, 6 rebounds, and all of these schools that are stepping up to try to get Cassius Stanley at 6'5", class of 2019. Think about it, Alabama, Arizona, Arizona State, Gonzaga, Kansas, LSU, Maryland, Oklahoma, Oregon, UCLA, UNLV, USC. I mean, everybody after Cassius Stanley. He's one of our captains today. And on the flip side, Jamias Ramsey, a transfer no less, 14.7 at Nike EYBL, which I think is really kind of a standard to look at when it comes to statistics, because there's so many big players in that event. Nike EYBL averaging 14.7. And in the Peach Jam this year, he averaged 18.4 points per game. And again, big schools for him too: Arkansas, Baylor, Florida, Maryland, North Carolina State, Texas, Virginia, Texas A&M. I mean, he was the one-on-one champ, and he was spectacular last night. And he'll be transferring and going to Oak Hill with a lot of big names too. Some other big names: Cole Anthony, Chandler Lawson, Cam Thomas, Coffee Cockburn. I mean, that'll be a stacked squad with Jamias Ramsey. And we'll see today if he can captain his side to victory over Cassius Stanley.
I think it's a good plot inside the plot. You know, I think it's good for the fan, good for me and you. You know, when you see all this talent and then you get these standout guys and they have to blend in and do their thing as well. So I'm really, really looking forward to it.
Of course.
Got my home girl.
So it's been a real treat, man. It's been a real treat to watch all of these guys kind of get the New York City experience courtesy of Slam and courtesy of Dyckman, because again, we've talked about it here on the show. I mean, there's so many legendary venues in New York City.
Thank you for coming out.
Rucker Park, Dyckman.
Look who we got. Look who just checked in on the broadcast.
Oh, my God, Teresa Witherspoon behind us.
We just want to do this for New York City right now. Teaspoon, quite naturally, a big part of our family, you know, attends all the games all over the city, Orchard Beach, Dyckman, wherever. And for her to come out today and again support these high school players, support these ladies, not only tells you what she's about, tells you what New York City's about. Good to see you, T, and how's it feel?
It's always good to be back in this area, especially to get an opportunity to see how young women play. It's always amazing because you often wonder the hands you lead the game in. And when you see these young ladies as talented as they are and as versatile as they are, the ability and the agility that they have, you know the game is in great hands.
Great. Great. Appreciate
I mean, I think it's great, Teaspoon, to see the girls get the love as well. I mean, they kind of set the tone so far for us. Really exciting game. And basketball in the city is alive and well.
Absolutely. And it's good what you just said is the women started this thing and we set the tone. See, I like the sound of that, setting the tone. And when we are considered the first game in a tournament like this with our young people, it's about setting the tone. Everything we do is about setting the tone. And our young people are definitely doing that. And what you all are doing for them, the exposure, is so valuable, it's so important, because it means something to them. We can practice all day long, but the support means so much to these young people. You guys are doing a heck of a job, and it's so good to see.
Wow, man.
I don't mean to be this close to you. I'm just trying to give you my microphone.
I love it.
Even though you are a basketball legend.
I love it. I thank you so much. Thank you all
Thank
you for stopping by.
Teaspoon, New York City at the height. New York
awesome,
Liberty.
Awesome job. Great to see
Thank you. Thank you.
I mean, and you can see the stars are out already, folks, and we want to ask you another poll question. What is the song of the summer? Now, you saw Mo Bamba at the park for one of the slam showdowns. He was saying to me, actually, he said, I think I'm more famous from this song from Sheck West than I am for actually being a basketball player. So
wow.
That's one of the songs of the summer.
Up for
we got,
Grammy?
Yeah, of course. We got Feet Feet from 6ix9ine. We got okay. In My Feelings from Drake,
of
and
course.
I Like It from Cardi B. Now, G,
whoa.
You know, as much infatuation as I have for Cardi B, I'm actually going to take the Drake song, In My Feelings, as the song of the summer.
Because you like the way the girls dance,
too. I mean, she's beautiful. She is beautiful. I'm hoping that she stops by as well on the stream for us, even though Teaspoon was definitely a special treat.
That was lit
for me. And you could tell, folks, we were not prepared for that because we didn't even have a microphone for her.
Impromptu, but
so
it was just the love.
Stuff.
It was just the love. And Teaspoon, a big part of what we do here to support, as she says so.
Sitting courtside for the girls' game today. And again, folks, remember, you have to type the full answer in the comment box on the stream to let us know who you think the best, you know, either where you're watching the game from or what the best song of the summer is or who the MVP will be, that kind of thing. You have to type the full answer into the comment box. And we've got even more stars coming. Looks like Lance Stephenson in the building. So the NBA players are here for this one. It doesn't matter if it's not a night game, folks. It does not matter.
Exactly.
Dyckman Park is a drawing card for New York City basketball in this game. Is a drawing card for New York City basketball.
And cha-ching,
just about set to start calling out the plays on the blacktop. And he is the voice of Dyckman, no doubt about
it. He has been amazing
this summer.
Man, doing games with Ching is like a treat.
I missed out on the song of the summer, G. They
went
Mo Bamba.
Are you serious? Over Drake?
They went Mo Bamba. I guess, you know, again, his love here in the park might have been a big part of that.
I think they kind of rigged it with the Dyckman crowd, but still, shout to Mo Bamba and all the other participants. 2018.
Drafted by the Orlando Magic.
Okay. Official Slam Showdown Volume 1. Bobby C. Uncle G. Dyckman Park.
Let's go, baby. Let's go, fellas. Let's
and the
go.
Numbers are jumping all over Facebook. A lot more love for Mo Bamba here at 50% now. In My Feelings, though, is second, G, at 27.3.
Getting some love.
It is getting some love. And I Like It by Cardi B. Coming in last at
Shout
the moment.
To
so as beautiful as she is, she's not getting the
God,
attention.
Bobby, please.
The attention that she deserves in the song department.
You want beef with Offset?
Yeah, I would take it. Why not? For Cardi B, sure.
Offset had just had a pistol case.
As long as he's not in the park, I don't want to get shot here.
Just had a gun case. You got to relax. Shout to Set.
So we will give you the lineups as we go along. This one will be much easier to do because, again, these
magical.
Names,
exactly.
Everybody's
they speak name
for
brand.
Themselves.
Everybody's
yeah.
got on a flyer. Everything's name brand. Okay.
Opening tap will be number 23, James Wiseman in black for Team Ramsey. On the flip side, it will be number 2, Jaden McDaniels. McDaniels coming out of Federal Way High School in Washington, the class of 2019. And Wiseman out of East High School in Memphis, Tennessee, also the class of 2019.
Gala.
Voice of Dyckman geared up for this one, and
yes,
so are
is.
We. We are just about set to get rolling.
Look good.
James Wiseman being recruited by Arizona, Florida State, Kansas, Kentucky, Memphis, North Carolina, Texas, Vanderbilt. He played for the Bluff City Legends. He was the centerpiece of that team. He had 16 points at Peach Jam on average with 5.8 rebounds and 2.2 blocks. He has really exploded this summer at 7 feet tall and 230 pounds. The center, albeit undeclared, is on the NBA radar. And again, we talked about it in our last showdown, too, that it's possible that by 2020, G, you might not have that one-and-done rule in the NBA. So a guy like Wiseman
could be going straight in the league. You said that about Kyree Walker as well.
And the opening tap, and we are underway. Team Ramsey with the first possession, and the crowd already on its feet.
Yeah, they like this one here.
Deshaun Davis fires, unable to hit. The follow, there's Wiseman, almost throws down the jam. Back on the other end, looking to fast break it. And the first bucket will be scored by number 4, Jalen Green, out of Fresno, California, the class of 2020.
See him a little hanging on the rim there. Oh!
And a quick return of the favor. That one long range, so a 3-2 start. There is Cassius Stanley, the captain and the dunk champ on the left wing.
Got a lot to prove, baby.
Little shake and bake. He'll fire from three.
Okay.
And he knocks it down the trifecta. Yeah. Oh, doctor.
And he tricked him that time because, you know, he won the dunk contest yesterday. So what? I could do it from the perimeter. Cassius.
This game is lit already, folks.
Yes, it is.
Down Death Valley in the land of the Giants. Misfire. There's Wiseman trying to pull down the rebound. And back comes Cassius Stanley. He'll take it over the TikTok on the left side. Dancing and prancing with the rock. He's got the dribble. He's got the shake and bake. He's got a hand in his face, but he'll fire on the rainbow shot. No good. Offensive rebound. And McDaniels giving it back to Stanley, who throws down a tough jam in the lane.
No, it's completely understood, Bobby. Pace, attitude, early. You see young Cassius, man, already feeling good.
Jamias Ramsey, the other captain, and again, the newest transfer at Oak Hill. With almost a vicious jam.
I mean, Bobby, how could you not do your thing when you get a chance here?
Kyree Walker, yes. Already committed to Arizona State. And he was the biggest star of our 6 I'm slam showdowns. He's picks already, up his first basket in the Slam Summer Classic.
He's already acclimated.
Baseline, that is Noah Farrakhan.
When you talk about Kyree Walker, you talk about a guy that already came out here and got on the Walk of Fame. And you talk about a kid that came out here and played to the crowd, had the masses with him, and no different today. He's back for more.
Noah Farrakhan comes in at 6'1", about 170 pounds, class of 2020, out of Newark, New Jersey, playing ball right now at IMG Academy in Florida. Shot a runner. And Farrakhan can't get it to go. We'll take it back the other way. 15:36 here in the first. We'll play 2 18-minute halves. That jump shot missed by Jalen Green for Team Stanley. Back on the other end, there is Davis going coast to coast. The host with the most. NYC love right there, Jay.
And I'm telling you, he's always got something to prove. You watch number 12 in black, you put him in that spotlight. He does this all the time. It's almost like his paw. Shout the reins.
Deshaun Davis out of OSL, Our Savior Lutheran High School in the BX. Shot taken
BX
there is off the
mark.
James Wiseman, the big fella. And he draws a little bit of a double team now on the crossover up around the charity stripe. He fires and connects. Big fella's got the soft touch.
Now, that was a natural touch too, Bobby. You know, he never hesitated. He never thought twice about it. He got it up over the defender and had the good touch.
And another charity strike knockdown. That one scored by Jaden McDaniels. Again, out of Washington, the kid can play.
You can see that in Jaden right there, man. And they go right back to the matchup, man. Matchup already sizzling hot here. Hey, big fella showing handle, Bobby. Wow.
And Wiseman is fouled on the play. And, you know, listen, McDaniels didn't win the dunk contest, but he put on a show yesterday. Indoors as, again, another appetizer for this event. We had a couple of other polls, too, folks. What's the best sneaker to hoop in? Is it the Kyrie 4? Is it the LeBron 15? Is it the Kobe AD NXT 360 or the KD 2?
A lot of good sneakers, man.
We've also tried to engage our Facebook Nation to ask them who their favorite player from New York is. I highlighted some of the guys in this game. We got Davis and Andre Jackson and Jalen Lecque and Joe Toussaint and Zachary Fremantle. Jalen Lecque with 55% of the vote so far.
So an early favorite. Things could change.
Joe Girard is the all-time leading scorer in New York State history. It doesn't matter.
Doing too much.
Right now, Jalen LeCue getting all the love in the polls.
13:40 here, first half. Bobby C, Uncle G. It's the Slam Showdown Championship Game, Volume 1. And, man, we lit in Dyckman. You got to be here, Bobby, to feel this energy. We talked about the energy all the other games, but I'm talking about this one here for the last licks. We smell it and see it. Be part of it.
And the isolation here, Kyree Walker, number 23 in white. And a nice move there. Unable to finish, though. Good defense there by Andre Jackson, number 14.
And the kids are hyped up on defense. I see them trying to stop each other, refusing to become a poster or a memory.
And there is Sharife Cooper, G. Kisses it off the glass for two.
I like that hairstyle, Bobby. Young Sharife letting it all hang out. Good layup off the other side.
Class of 2020 out of Powder Springs, Georgia. That one, a top of the key trifecta. The dagger right between the eyes.
I know one thing. The D1 level is in trouble when you look at these kids, Bobby. They are, because there's so much talent, man. Oh.
So let's give you these lineups again. Team Ramsey in the white, led by their captain, Cassius Stanley. On the floor for them, number four is Jalen Green. Just checking in is Zachary Fremantle. Zach will be wearing number 25 today at a Bergen Catholic. Well, Joe Girard, the third.
Yeah. Favorite nephew status.
Favorite nephew. He was in one of the showdowns.
Joe Girard, yeah. Zion.
He's wearing number 11 today.
Zach, yeah. There's a lot of them out there, man.
Number one is Zion Harmon, your favorite.
I love Zion, boy.
He was another star on the showdowns. Zion.
Boy, did he light this joint up.
Now coming in off the bench.
Favoriteness. It doesn't matter today. That doesn't have nothing to do with it today, about coming off the bench and when you get in. You get in, Dyckman got your back. You got to show out.
And Zion going to work over the TikTok. Jalen Green, the other starter for Team Stanley, giving you the five guys on the floor right now. There's Zion Harmon taking it to the 10. And the defensive rebound, now the alley-oop. And there's the jam. Number 23, James Wiseman, needs little introduction out of East High School, Memphis, Tennessee, the big fella.
Yeah, but that's his second bucket that made him look good. Girard the third. No, I'm talking about the last dunk from the big fella, Bobby. Making it look easy, man. DJ Zookeeper, Bobby C, Uncle G, good people of Dyckman. Know the drill.
A two-point game as we come up on the 11-minute marker in the first half of play. Girard's three-point attempt was stopped there by the whistle. We'll have the inbound, and there is R.J. Hampton, who has just checked in. I'll give you the guys for Team Ramsey in black. R.J. Hampton, they call him. R.J. is government name, G, is Roderick. Don't call me Roderick. R.J. Hampton.
Okay.
There's James Wiseman with a left-handed jam.
I like his positioning. You know, I think he's a guy that frees himself up, Bobby, when he doesn't have the ball. I like the way he plays out here.
And the assist by Sharife Cooper, number two. A nice play by the playmaker. There is Jalen Green trying to take his man off the
Now, that was good recovery on the defense, man.
Good defense there by
Hampton. Yeah, that was great recovery on the defense there.
He's wearing number five. Hampton's father played at Southern Methodist, G, and he also played in the pros at the CBA level and in Europe as well.
Wow.
So Bobby, the now defunct CBA.
Talk about not only with Lance Stephenson and Teaspoon and all these people being in the house, talk about the pressure that comes with a big crowd, a big day. You know, you get out here, you hear about this game all week on social media. So what goes through a player's mind when it's his chance to perform? It's got to be a lot of pressure, a lot of anxiety.
I mean, listen, again, they're getting national attention for playing here this afternoon.
And a good move right there with the foul under the basket, number two in black.
And I think they want to show out not just for the fans, but for their peers.
Exactly,
for
their families,
who are here today.
Yeah, so much different dynamic.
And again, you know, listen, G, we live now in the age where everything's about the social media and the gram and, you know, Facebook too. So when you have a bad performance, everyone in the world knows about it.
Exactly. Same way when you have a good one.
Now, we mentioned about the New York City players. Again, we go back to the polls. What's the best sneaker to hoop? And I mentioned it, the Kyrie 4, the LeBron 15, the Kobe AD NXT 360, or the KD 2. Let us know what you think. What are you wearing when you're out there at the park?
I know one thing. Me and you can use any one of those.
Zion Harmon.
My boy.
Dancing and prancing with the rock, but the fancy dribbling doesn't really matter here at Dyckman. Tomahawk jam. Oh, goodness. And that was Cliff. Omarori. Omarori. Remember the name. Yeah, out of Montclair. 6'10", 235 pounds out of Immaculate Conception High School. Clifford Omarori.
Big kid.
He is a big kid, no doubt.
Big Cliff.
Welcome to the zoo.
You see how these kids sprout up, Bobby, at these ages. I mean, me and you, we stayed the same size. But when you look at the 21st century guy, and this generation, these guys are NBA ready at 15, man. 16, they're like LeBron.
I mean, Cliff is actually class of 2020. I mean, that's ginormous already.
Exactly.
At the free throw line is Jalen Green, so out of San Joaquin Memorial High School in Fresno, California.
Facebook Live, make sure you pipe in. Let us know where you're at, what you're doing, man. We love you guys. The support has been enormous. Again, a colossal day here at Dyckman Park. The final game of the Slam Showdown Volume 1. It is big out here. I ain't talking about Biggie Small.
R.J. Hampton, a big player in this game, and he didn't pick up the bucket, but he picks up an assist in a way as the big fella there again. Cliff. The jam.
I think with Cliff, you just got to put it up there. You know, just put it up there by the basket, and then Cliff
we gonna get one good segment and
closes it out. 7:29.
And a nice play there by Jalen. And it's still a two-point game. Hampton won a gold medal with the 2017 FIBA Americas Under 16 at the championship. It was also a 2018 USA Today All-Texas first-teamer.
Good jump shot right there from the left side. And gets 7:06 remaining, 21-17. A lot of showing off.
From three-point land, dialing long distance, Jalen Green.
Wow, Jalen built for the moment, Bobby. You see the crowd really, really starting to pack in.
And now this is what the park wants. They want Hampton Green. They want Hampton Green. RJ! And he splashes it from the outside.
Yep.
And maybe he's got the Kyrie 4s on. I don't know.
I don't know what
those are.
But right
now the fans think that that's the shoe to wear, 66%.
Yeah, so shout to Kyrie.
Oh, he went top of the key, three with a hand in his face. No for Jalen Green. Back comes Wiseman over the TikTok. He'll give it up to Hampton, and they want this matchup.
Yeah,
RJ
like
wearing number 5G in black.
I like RJ.
Roderick, what do you got for me? No! RJ Hampton misfires on the three. Here comes Joseph Girard. A little crossover. He'll fire from three. That one's short. Still looking for his first basket. Zachary Fremantle back outside. And James Wiseman with the blocks, G.
I like it.
RJ coast to coast. But a whistle will stop the action.
Making a special name for himself.
We'll have full timeout, it looks like, Jake.
Slam Showdown, Uncle G Stacks, Bobby C, the voice, DJ Zookeeper, the good, good people of Dyckman, and man, we told you. Slam Showdown 2018, man. You got to be here to see it.
So on the floor now for Team Ramsey, Joe Toussaint out of Cardinal Hayes High School, right here in the box. He's wearing number 4.
Okay.
You got Ramsey. You got Sharife Cooper back out there. He's the one with the rock right now, number 3.
Stolen.
Is Noah Farrakhan in the steal. And the Tomahawk Jam, yes, indeed, by Josh Christopher.
5:41 here to the half.
We talked about the favorite players from New York. How about your favorite player from California? Is it Cassius Stanley, Josh Christopher, or Jalen Green, who's
three.
Already been off to a great start?
Especially that Cassius Stanley, boy. I'm telling you, he done made a name for himself out here in New York. Good matchup here.
More isolation, trying to take advantage of the white boy. Davis.
Not Joe Girard III, buddy. And Rams that time. So easy easily gets to the basket. That time the good put.
And that's what they call Deshaun Davis. They call him Rams, Rams TV.
Yeah, I like Rams.
He's being looked at by Arkansas, Little Rock, Fordham, Hofstra, LaSalle, Manhattan. He had a big game here at the Summer Stacks between Skull Gang and Harlem for Life, where he knocked a defender off his feet after a stutter step.
Wow.
Now, he didn't knock his defender off his feet, but I'll tell you, number three right there, Josh Christopher with the three-pointer. And that shot went viral, by the way, for
of
Rams,
course.
Deshaun Davis. Everything
good
right now,
here. This
all about the viral sensations.
Uh-uh. That's what it is.
The layup is easy buckets for Joe Toussaint, another Bronx boy, class of 2019.
4 minutes and 36 seconds, and you know, we don't want the viewers to lose the fact it's a big game. It's just a lot of excitement.
Kyree Walker with the bucket.
Of course. But you know, like you said, individually, with guys having to kind of impress and do their thing, it kind of sometimes subtracts from the team concept. But all these kids can play.
Jalen Green, overwhelmingly the pick from California.
Wow.
Noah Farrakhan taking his defender.
Ooh. Shades
right
Steph
to the
Curry,
10, man.
You heard
right
it.
To the 10.
Mixed you up, put you on the blender, laid you up.
And if I'm correct, it looks like Noah Farrakhan is like, is that a toothpick in his mouth? I mean,
oh, no.
Is he styling and profiling NYC style?
Yes, he is. You know, New York.
And the baseline finish there.
What bigger
Joe
stage
Girard
to show off than New York, Bobby? New York full of show offs, man. Come on. 3:42 remaining.
Girard has narrowed his college choices down to Michigan, Syracuse, Duke, Notre Dame, Penn State, Boston College. We should know soon about where New York's all-time leading scorer is going. That one rejected. Cassius. Oh, Kyrie is. He's stunting, my friend.
Fan favorite. He said it in the interview. I'm going to play my game and they can't stop me. Good matchup here. Got Kyrie on deep. Okay. Okay. I like this.
Ching fueling the hype.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I like this.
And he points to the sky right there as that three comes raining down from downtown.
Exactly. DJ
Joe Toussaint, by the way. We had already highlighted him. He had just knocked down the trifecta. Joe doing his thing here in the NYC.
Yeah, like
Kyrie
him.
Walker trying
they
to
go back to the matchup. Yeah.
Mano Imano Walker from three. That one clanks off the front iron.
You know, even the fans can be a little selfish sometimes, Bobby. You know, when you talk about Dyckman and, like you said, the viral sensation and the chance to get online and put your stuff up. So it's kind of selfish in that regard because that's what the fans want to see, even at the expense of the game. Matched up.
I'm curious who's going to end up having an interview at the halftime, G, because there's been a lot of stars so far here in the first half. Joe fires again. Here is Girard on the rebound. He'll bring it up over the timeline on the right side against Davis. And Davis takes it away. Hands in the cookie jar, the steal, and now the jam. The exclamation point for Davis.
Call it home court advantage, all right?
Back Rams. The other way we go. Another long-range trifecta, this time a bit short, but the follow and the putback by Team Stanley's number two, Jaden McDaniels. Another hoop for him.
He's been having him.
It's a one-point game, folks. This one tight as tight can be. Hampton.
I told you, it's still a good game.
Trying to shake off his man. That shot, an oxygen ball. He was looking for a call, though, by the officials. That one sails out of bounds. We'll take it back the other way. So Team Stanley will have possession. Hampton
131
on the defense. And there it is, the steal. Now they've got the numbers, the 3-on-2. RJ Hampton, I'll take it myself. No, he misfired on the dunk. And there's Stanley bringing it back. Cassius Stanley, that's how you do it. Excuse me while I kiss the sky, Cassius Stanley.
Verticals on display this afternoon in New York City, Bobby. Everybody showing the hops. 1 minute remaining here.
And Ramsey rejected.
Meet me at the top, baby.
And he was unstoppable in that matchup yesterday of one-on-one.
Yeah, it looks like it, too.
We talked about him a lot in the pregame. He's got some impressive accolades and some impressive numbers. And that Oak Hill team, man, it's going to be something else this year. Cole Anthony, Chandler Lawson, Cam Thomas, Coffee Cockburn, and Jamias Ramsey. Kyrie Walker. G-Stacks.
JoJo.
You going to put JoJo Swift at the half? Wow.
Nah, he said JoJo Swift saying G-Stacks, greatest of all time. You know, JoJo Swift.
Well, it would be nice for you to talk to him, too, at the halftime. But I guess we got to interview some of these guys,
no,
right?
JoJo Swift is chiming in.
to say that you're the greatest of all time. We know that already, JoJo. Yeah. We know he's the
JoJo,
best of all time.
JoJo, I love you, man. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my Brooklyn Stompers family, JoJo. Favorite nephew for all times, man. You the greatest, too.
Buckets for Ramsey. He's trying to be the greatest of all time.
Yeah. Wow, JoJo, that's my boy, man. Means a lot, Joe.
And that was Jaden McDaniels again.
Hey, with 29 seconds, man, who can we grab?
We are tied at 37 after that basket by McDaniels. Can Ramsey break the tie? Tries the long-range three, no good. There is Stanley, the other captain, off the backboard. Oh, how did he do that?
Hey.
Oh, goodness. Cassius Stanley.
Hey, Kenny.
I'll tell you, one of those schools, Alabama, Arizona, Arizona State, Gonzaga, Kansas, LSU, Maryland, Oklahoma, Oregon, UCLA, UNLV, USC. Who's it going to be for Cassius Stanley? We'll follow there at the buzzer. Yes.
Okay. Who are we going to grab?
We got Cass T. Porter. Let's work, baby.
That was Joe Toussaint.
Who should we grab?
He's had a nice first half, too. I mean, G-Stack's trying to figure out right now with our producers who we should talk to at the half. Can we interview all of them? I mean, we should interview all of them. Folks, you're watching the Slam Summer Classic courtside. Uncle G Stacks, I'm Bobby C. Halftime here at the park. Folks, in just a moment, we'll come back with Uncle G Stacks here at the intermission, at the break, and he'll get a chance to catch up with the dunk champion, Cassius Stanley, the captain of his own team today, Team Stanley, our team in white. And again, what a game so far. We are tied at 39. Joe Toussaint had that buzzer beater to knot it up at the halftime. The park right now is electric. We'll get a chance to listen to what Cassius Stanley has to say about playing in the first ever Slam Summer Classic. Stay tuned, folks. More coming up.
Halftime interview. I got Cassius Stanley and the fans at home, man. I can't hold you up a long time. The fans just want to know, how do you do it? The dunk, the energy. What is it that gets into you and makes you show off like that here in the biggest park in New York?
It's that killer mentality. I mean, I got love for all the coasts, but I'm from LA and we do it different out in LA. But this is fun, man. It's a great park, great players. I want to be out here all the time, man. It's great basketball.
So talk a little bit about the difference. We know you're an L.A. guy. We saw you at the one-on-one. We saw you at the Slam Dunk concert. Talk about the environment as opposed to what it's like in California when there's somebody good as you.
In Los Angeles, we got the Drew League, and that's a prestigious thing, too, out here like Dyckman and Rucker. And this is great, too, because here it's just one-on-one basketball, and Drew League is real basketball. They're both great. I mean, I'm having fun here. It's a great environment, man.
So we're not going to hold you up, Cassius. Just wanted to thank you for coming out. Man, you're doing a great job. And a shout to Slam. Thank you. That's Uncle G Stacks, man. Best player at the half. Had a good time.
Slam, you know what's going on. Let's do it.
That was our halftime interview with Cassius Stanley, the dunk champ, and of course the captain of Team Stanley, the team in white. Great job by Uncle G Stacks. Folks, it is a scorcher here in the park for more reasons than one. First, it's another very hot, humid August day here in New York City. But more importantly, the action on the blacktop is as hot could be. Our first half deadlocked at 39 apiece. Team Stanley taking on Team Ramsey. The first ever Slam Summer Classic, volume number one. We've had six showdowns here on Facebook Live. The stream has been popping. We've had a chance to build up to the big day, and this is it. This is, as Uncle G Stacks likes to say, for all the tea in China. And again, we're going to go back to the polls as we kickstart the second half. Which school do you want to see Jalen LeCue hoop at? after his high school days are over. Is it UCLA? Is it Oregon? Is it TCU? Is it NC State? Is it Louisville? Is it Texas Tech?
How about that, Cassius?
He's been really killing it in the polls. And Cassius Stanley was killing it yesterday, and he's killing it again today.
And let me tell you something. You made me grab him, you know, because you put me on to the kid, and then I saw a little bit of talent out here. I saw a few flashes. But in the interview, Bobby, a real Californian and loves it here. You know, is excited about the opportunity to come out here and show his stuff. So shout to Cassius, favorite nephew for today.
G-Stacks, I know you're usually the guy that gives all of the shout-outs, but while we have a quick minute here during the halftime, I think it's appropriate that we send so much love to everyone that's been involved with this project. I tried to jot down as many names. Hopefully, I'll get everybody here at some point during the broadcast on the stream to give them thanks.
Wow.
But I really wanted to give a special thanks to really three guys in particular. One is Jason Aaron, who's doing such a great
right
job.
Wrong,
Alex
Jason,
Squadron. And sitting right next to us is Scott Railing. And he's done a great job, too, here in the park.
Why do you think the numbers are so high? Why do you think that the broadcast is
these are the guys
stream?
Behind the scenes
exactly.
that you don't see.
Exactly.
Even Spiro helping us out with the rosters.
It's just production giants, man. And I speak about these guys all the time.
I wanted to thank him for these few games as well. And we really have to also thank the two big CEOs, Dennis Page for Slam.
Wow.
Kenny Stevens out here at Dyckman. The president of Dyckman.
Exactly.
He's kind of like the mayor of the streets.
Right
Kenny
along.
Stevens.
Right along.
Also some shouts for Franklin Kaye, Adam Figman, we call him Figs, Chad Babel, David Scherner, Susan Price Thomas, Sarah Housenecht, Peter Robert Casey, who was in the building last night.
Beautiful.
Max Resitar, Ian Pierno, Arvin Pichai, Christian Quisada, Andy Hahn. I think I'm getting everybody right here, G.
Man, you got everybody,
Lester
man.
Lester Padilla, Joseph Sherman.
So many people
Michael
deserve
Yari,
it.
Michael Yari. And Josh Frohlinger, too.
Yeah.
I'll probably end up missing somebody and getting in trouble with someone.
No, because everybody that, you know.
But I definitely wanted to give some special shout-outs because, you know.
The
you
whole
guys,
production,
yeah,
exactly.
Yeah, you guys see us on the air.
Yeah, and they think it's just cute. You know, they think, well, these guys sound good, look good. No, but there's so many people behind us that make sure this thing goes right. From back in Texas
Dave
to downtown.
Scherner.
Shout to Dave. And it's just been a magical moment for me. You know, my first real big gig at a broadcast, and it's been magical, man, for real. Shout to Slam. Shout to DJ Zookeeper. Live.
Back to live action. Kyree Walker gets it started here in the second half, but he misfires. Here comes Ramsey. Down the middle of the drop off and the jam. That's the way to start the second half. James Wiseman.
Big fella at it again, man.
Walker, bounce pass. That one up on the glass. No good. 1942. We are underway, if you haven't noticed. And the jams are free-flowing. The fans have packed this place to the point that we got more people on the court again where we can barely see here courtside. Sharife Cooper guarded closely. The defense
solid afternoon,
has
man.
Been solid so far on
yeah.
both sides. I would
I told
Cooper,
you, I gave them kudos earlier. These kids are still locked in to play
he's
deep.
He's got the handle. And now it is Ramsey tiptoeing along the baseline, comes back on the other side, and the shot in the corner is no good. And now they'll look to push. They've got the two-on-one, and the layup is easy buckets there.
Congratulations.
For number five, Terrence Clark, who we haven't had a chance to talk about yet, out of Wilboro, New Hampshire, class of 21, one of the young guys here in the game. Brewster Academy's own Terrence Clark.
All right, Terrence.
Davis on the floor. Rams, Rams TV. Against Zion Harmon. Now Davis fires, and he buries the three.
It's a regular, man, with this kid, man. Rams TV from downtown. He's gonna show that little handle. Uh-oh.
Zion
favorite
Harmon.
Nephew. Uh-oh.
Marshall County, Zion
hey,
Harmon.
Hey, hey.
And he takes it to the 10. He banks it off the window. Zion Harmon.
Favorite nephew status. He said it in the interview. He loves it here.
Zion, matched up. 5'11", 175 pounds, class of 2021. And he was a star at the showdown. We'll see if Davis now on the matchup can do the same. Rams TV, body bumping, backs his way down. Buckets! Buckets for Davis!
Yeah.
It's a three-point game. Zion Harmon, what do you got for me, buddy?
How about cha-ching, ching?
And cha-ching, oh my goodness.
Ching, the best in the city, man.
He's a star, and so is Zion Harmon, but not that time on the three. Wiseman, the touch pass. Ramsey, off the backboard. He tried the left-hander, no. Zion Harmon fires up the right side. Kyree Walker, aerial liftoff, no. And out of bounds.
Did you see the attempt just now?
Kyree Walker's got bunnies, man. Push, bouncy, whatever you want to describe it. He's got hops. Folks, we're in a New York state of mind. I'll tell you, there is no place in the world like Dyckman Park, especially when basketball is here center stage. This is the soul of the game.
Fans locked into
the fans
it,
fans are locked in, so are we. The slams like now. Mid-range one more. That's it. That's it. And the shot off the heel. On the rebound, back comes Team Ramsey, led by Deshaun Davis, OSL, in the Bronx, wearing uniform number 12, matched up against Zion Harmon. This is the matchup right here
getting juicy
to start the second half.
Yeah, 16:55 here, second half. Juicy. Oh, get out of here. And that time Zion with the good defense showing that he's out here to defend his title. He was chosen best player.
We're engaging our fans again with the polls, folks. And Jalen LeCue, again, our favorite player from New York, according to Facebook Nation, he's at 50%.
Wow.
Even Andre Jackson coming in with good numbers, 23.5. I think he's actually one of the overlooked guys in this game. Andre Jackson.
I respect the fans. The fans watching more than just the dribbling and dunking. You know, they know when a guy's MVP worthy. Zion.
Oh, and there's Davis. And Davis with a steal. Oh, but he doesn't get the score. The pass, two more, count it. But they still come up with a G.
Congratulations.
All about the baskets.
Look at Baby Love. Keep making it out of here. No way. Give me that one. Look at Cliff. He grabbed everything. Good. Well,
and now Ramsey with the rebound.
One time sharing
Davis
is caring.
Sharing is caring. You are right.
It's got to be difficult
you
for a coach.
You are right.
It's got to be difficult for a coach, Bob, because you want to get everybody in. You know, you fly guys in, you bring them in from all over the nation, and you get them on a big stage. You want to get a guy shot at 15 minutes of fame, but then it's hard to pull a guy that's paying good. So the coaching, again, a good job out here giving the fans what they want to see.
Gee, we talked about it again. You got 20 of the best high school players in the country. Only five of them can start on each side. You got 20 great players in the game itself, and there are going to be guys that kind of get a little bit overlooked.
Exactly.
And cha-ching out there, you are right, looking like Rick James.
No, I'm telling you, man, Mr. Chidris.
Styling and profiling. Andre Jackson, by the way, G, is out of Albany, New York, class of 2020, and he's possibly bound for Syracuse, the Albany Academy star.
He drained that three there, man. That was nice looking there.
Another trifecta. That one scored by Terrence Clark, who we highlighted earlier.
Terrence, let that fly. I like that.
Noah Farrakhan on the floor. The teardrop out of control. But the putback attempt is not. And there is Andre Jackson, who I just mentioned.
Just to check out Ching in the Rick James outfit.
Just when you thought Rick James might not be with us anymore.
Nah, Rick James in the building, man. Oh, get that out of here. You just talked about the defense, Bobby.
You
just talked about it.
The boy can play. Andre Jackson! Oh, my goodness, he just tore down the rim. And now playing some defense, too, but he can't stop number two in white, and that is Jaden McDaniels.
Another good putback for the big fella there, paying attention as it came off the rim. 14-13 remaining here in the game. Slam, volume one, showdown here at Dyckman Park. Uncle G, Bobby C.
Not bad. Maybe not as good as the slam dunk championship yesterday, but a goodie right there.
Cali in the building.
And the finger roll. Joe Toussaint has put on an impressive performance.
I like this California flavor, though, Bobby. I do. I like these kids coming out here in another environment.
New York versus California.
I like that. You said that, too.
Joe Toussaint out of the BX.
Wow.
That one off the heel. Rebounded by Wiseman. And here comes R.J. Hampton. He'll bring this one up over the TikTok. Right down the middle. Hampton now on the left side.
RJ with a hell of a game this afternoon.
Guarded closely there by Josh Christopher, and he can't finish. With a whistle.
DJ Zookeeper, man, knocking it out the park. Voice of Dyckman, cha-ching. Last licks of the summer, man. Dyckman.
So Hampton fouled on the play, of course. He'll head to the free throw line. RJ Hampton, under 13 minutes to go in this one. You almost don't want it to end, right, G?
I mean, look, you see the kids ready for school. You see everybody geared towards September, guys. Minds on getting back to school. But this here is still an epic moment, Bobby, in your summer 18. And it's a way to close it out. You get the best players from across the country, best announcers, best music. Yeah, we live.
This game close enough to potentially be an overtime game. That turnaround on the long range, no good. There's Gerard with the second effort. Joseph Gerard, the third. Yes, I do score 50 a game in high school.
You see that bounce on him, too. And he's a kid. He can light it up at any time. 12-26 remaining here.
Joe Toussaint, New York City's own. Joe to the cup, and oh, he's got the spin cycle. Yeah, Joe Toussaint.
Put him in the blender right there. Joe Toussaint.
Jason Michael, this is Street Ball at its finest. Thank you for watching on Facebook Live. Joe Toussaint gets it back. Now the alley and the reverse, no good. Wiseman, oh, that's the way you put back the jam. The left-hander by the big fella, James Wiseman.
Yeah, that's the lottery. Time to keep two more. One more, how you feeling?
McDaniels, fall away three. Hand in his face, tough shot to make, but they get the offensive rebound. Now there's Gerard. And that's how you score. Yes, I am New York's all-time leading scorer. Joseph Gerard, the third, over 3,000 points.
Okay.
Now it's Joe versus Joe. Which average Joe? Joe Toussaint, shaking, baking, manipulating, thriving, conniving, and mesmerizing. Joe Toussaint score the goal.
Dyckman Park at his best. And here go the favorite white boy, the favorite nephew, Joe Gerard. I score 50 up.
For three off the heel, Wiseman on the rebound, and Joe Toussaint coming back. Mano a mano for three. That one right of the rim. Oh, Wiseman! Are you kidding me? He elevated above the rim, caught the rebound, and they tossed it home for two.
Swag a little different out of 14 in black. I respect it.
Terrence Clark, trifecta. No. On the rebound, back comes Team Ramsey in black. RJ Hampton down the left side with a little assist there from Cha-ching, a.k.a. Rick James. RJ Hampton on the cross, right-hand dribble down the lane. Big shot is good for RJ Hampton.
Good team play right there. Way to cut, way to lock it in off the rim, off the backboard, excuse me, and get the easy deuce. 2018 Slam Showdown.
The MVP voting is coming up next. You've got 1 minute. And we'll be starting this MVP voting, one for each team, so be advised.
Yeah.
Two votes going at the same time.
You That's folks right. have been great, man.
We wanted to let the fans know you got to type the full name, the last name, in the comments. One for each team. Let us know who the most valuable player of the game is for Team Ramsey and Team Stanley. That's like my Lambo right there to the 10. And a foul.
Slam Showdown in the building. Slam Summer Classic Volume 1, man. Wow.
Yeah, this park is going H.
And this is just what I think the city needed.
I had to censor myself right there, Jim.
Be careful. But I think this is what the city needed. You know, I think this is a big lift.
Money section.
Kids going back to school, you know, closing out your summer, man. You get a chance to see all this talent, all this future greatness. Zion.
So Jalen Green misfires on the free throw, and there is Zion Harmon to pick it up. Our MVPs on Team Cassius Stanley's side will be Mr. Stanley or Green or Walker. Let us know. Type it in, the full name on the Facebook stream.
Cassius, Green, and Walker. Come on, help us out. 927. Here.
Jalen Green, Cassius Stanley,
oh, Jesus.
And Rick James has seen Jesus. So is everyone else here. Zachary Fremantle, at a Bergen Catholic.
Big Zach.
And they do. They call him Baby Kevin Love for a reason.
What?
So Zachary G, as we can't even see anything anymore. The fans are just stacked here on the court. The reverse layup is good.
Dyckman takeover.
So Zach coming in at 6'8", 225 pounds, G, out of Bergen Catholic, being looked at by a lot of, oh, another trifecta. Being looked at by a lot of A-10 teams, St. Joe's, St. Bonaventure, and some of the Ivies, too. The kid is a smart kid. Princeton and Brown among the schools, looking at Zachary Fremantle. Speak of the devil. Baby Love, he averaged 18.9 points and 10.3 rebounds at Bergen Catholic. Zachary Fremantle, remember the name.
Big Zach, favorite nephew too, man.
There is Sharife Cooper, number two. For Team Ramsey, the MVP votes right now shaking out to be James Wiseman, of course, 57% of the vote. But Rams TV, Davis at 21, and Joe Toussaint, who's played extremely well, also coming in
like
at 21% at the moment.
That's
Joe
at Cardinal
Hayes High School in the Bronx. Zion Harbin down the left side. Oh, look at the dribble.
Kid's got a lot of flair, man.
Coming up on 8 minutes here in the second half.
We got the ladder raised up. Mr. Davis, all the New York players came to play.
So for Team Ramsey, that's Davis, Sharife Cooper, and Ramsey in the lineup. And Davis down the lane.
Good defense.
Cliff also in the lineup, number 25, and number 14 is Andre Jackson. There is Sharife Cooper. Off the backboard, there is Andre Jackson. A human highlight reel, Andre Jackson.
73-63 with 7:39 here in the Slam Showdown, Volume 1, Uncle G Stacks, Bobby C. Dyckman Park it is, baby.
Jackson about 6'5". He can play the shooting guard or the small forward.
Can't really see too much of the action.
I definitely lost that bucket off the backboard. There's another jam. Coming up on 7 minutes, and now the park is just absolutely out of control.
Yeah, Dyckman Day.
Again, we've talked about it in previous streams. I would say the park probably comfortably sits about 1,100.
But when they get in here like this?
It's over 2,000 people, and there are people outside the fence just trying to watch the game. How awesome was it to have Teresa Witherspoon in the pregame? That was awesome. Man.
Not only with Teaspoon, I was able to get over there and holler to Sir Lance a lot. And, you know, he loves it out here. And shout out to Lance and his future NBA, you know, dreams with LeBron. So, good day.
And the Liberty, too, Stacks, they're struggling this year. They could use Teaspoon.
You think so?
Yeah, they got less than 10 wins.
You used to be a Liberty guy.
I love all basketball.
I love
man.
Women basketball.
Men's, women's, boys, girls.
That's right.
And the jam. He loves basketball, too.
It's time to get tricky.
Yep. It is time, to,
time
get
to get tricky. Looking over the top,
six
of my
games.
Hey,
lift off. It's now become a dunk contest.
Well, I mean, that's what Slam really, really brought out here. You know, they brought these kids out here to show talent. Yeah, they want to win the game, but I think individually you want to see what these kids can do. And you sure saw it today. DJ Zookeeper, man, I hear you.
Sharife Cooper, alley, and Ramsey trying the left hand, no good. Again, engage us with our MVP voting right now on Facebook. We want to hear from you, Facebook Nation. Let us know who you think Team Ramsey's MVP should be and who Team Stanley's MVP should be. You're watching the Slam Summer Classic. We're here live at Dyckman Park in Inwood, Manhattan, courtside with the really the best in the business. I think we could give ourselves a little bit of love. Right, G? I've given love to so many of our staff members today, but Uncle G Stacks, the best commentator in the business. I like to think I'm the best when it comes the play-by-play. I'm the voice, Bobby C.
Ain't even close. And I think the nation and the world saw that these seven games.
And another spectacular jam. This time it's Jalen Green with the Aerials from Fresno, California. Looks like he was on a flight right there above the rim.
Like a holiday out here, Bobby.
And Davis from three. Yes, he cashes in and he gets a little love from Rick James.
Exactly.
Another alley-oop, Cassius Stanley from Kyree Walker.
Cali in the house.
And we talked about it. Stanley talked about having his West Coast reps.
Yeah.
We'll see if it'll be New York or California in this one.
Don't forget, folks, we still got a little time left. MVP voting. Team Ramsey, Davis, Wiseman, and Toussaint.
Really starting a freestyle, G.
Yeah, yeah.
Another long range. and the gun for Sharife Cooper.
I mean, when you come this far to this kind of park, Bobby, you want to get your little walk of fame, you know?
Get tricky and get it like a dancer.
Cooper's got speed. He's got cheetah-like quickness. That time could not finish, and there comes Zion Harmon. Gets it up to number four, Jalen Green. And you'll never see an NBA game with this many people on the baseline and on the sidelines.
How about all the phones out from the fans in the crowd? Recording the moment, Bobby.
The follow by Jalen Green. The Lord said you got to rise up. Jalen Green throws it down. 4:45 to go. And now the game's really got out of control. It's an 87-73 score with Davis and Zion Harmon going back to this matchup of one-on-one. Davis fires, unable to hit. And back comes Team Stanley in white. Another jam. Cassius Stanley. Wiseman leading the MVP vote right now overwhelmingly for Team Ramsey, and deservedly so. Let us know who you think the MVP should be for Team Stanley.
Gorgeous Saturday afternoon. Look at everybody all slammed out in the crowd. T-shirts everywhere. Man, it's a good look for New York City. I'm just proud. I'm happy for the kids. You know, we lose, Bobby, and I don't want to go into it, but we lose so many kids, you know, to so much negative stuff. And then when you get to see, you see an event like this, and New York City comes out like this, and it's predominantly kids, and they behave themselves, it gives us a lift as a community. So a shout to the whole culture, man, for making this thing pop.
And Jalen Green leading the MVP voting, folks, on the other side at 47.8%. That's the voice of Dyckman Park, cha-ching, dressed as the legendary Rick James this afternoon.
Nothing like
cha-ching. And that's something he does on the regular, too. He's like Michael Jackson.
Nah, he got it all going.
He's got Prince.
He got it all going.
A lot of different celebs.
Nobody get hurt. It's fine. Two more to move.
And a nice move there by Terrence Clark. He's put together a nice game as well.
Thanks to Slam family for bringing all the hitters out today.
3:45 to play. Sharife Cooper, too easy.
Hey, look at the MVP
y'all get to enjoy the moment that it ain't.
And Team Ramsey now leads 89-77.
Pretty neat.
That's it. One time.
Very cool.
Cassius headshot official.
And another vicious jam. 3:25 to go now. And again, it's become about the styling and profiling here in the closing minutes. You know, interesting to note, I don't know if the fans can see it on the screen, but the basketballs have a special Slam Summer Classic logo on it.
Wow.
And our MVPs will also get a very fresh pair of Nike kicks.
Yo, I got to talk to Dennis, man. I'm telling you.
That are decorated in our signature black, orange,
unbelievable,
and white. Those are the Jordan 1s.
Unbelievable. Shout to Slam. And look at that, man.
Shot from three is good. And at this point, 91-82, I think it's about who the MVP is going to be.
That's all it's about.
That shot from long range. It looked like Sharife Cooper. I can't even see right now. We got so many people in front of us.
7 minutes.
In the corner.
We good. Slam, we did it.
Another three-point attempt. Wiseman on the rebound. Sharife Cooper. And Gerard comes up with it. The lead pass. Cassius Stanley tries to dunk. The inbound there by Noah Farrakhan, and there is RJ Hampton. Hampton will bring this one over the TikTok on the left side.
Come on, first break, come on.
We got to admit, G, it's cool to see these young guys having fun here.
I'm having a ball myself.
It's turned into an all-star game now in the closing minutes, but for the first three quarters of this game, it was definitely very competitive.
And you saw some real talent.
Sharife Cooper and RJ Hampton hook up right there. Hampton with the basket. Both teams not playing as much defense now. Zachary Freeman.
Yeah.
There's Wiseman. James Wiseman. almost clobbers his teammate. Under 2 minutes to go now. Joe Girard, number 11.
Watch out, Joe. That's
no fire for three. Offensive rebound. And Zachary Fremantle. Wiseman still leading the MVP vote by a lot. He's at 51%.
Yeah, he's having a runaway, Bobby.
Hampton tried the up and under. Zachary Fremantle. Who did you have off the backboard? That would have been for Stanley. Noah Farrakhan. And the shot off the mark. I think both teams maybe a little tired, too, G.
I mean, how could you not be? A lot of energy, a lot of output today.
And it's turned it into a slam dunk show. Cassius Stanley.
Slam at the end.
Final
right?
minute. It's a 10-point game. We'll see if we get any more one-on-one matchups here. A steal for Stanley. And liftoff. Number three, Josh Christopher. Wiseman to finish this one off. Yes, the 360.
What an afternoon, Bobby. Everything we thought it would be, and some.
The Rock.
Stanley, number zero. Oh, yes. That probably should be how we end the game, right, Chief?
Right on. Greatest fans in the world coming out. Handling it today.
We're going to put another 4 or 5 minutes since we waited.
Wiseman gives his team 100 points, and they'll get the victory today.
Slam, thank you. Dyckman,
behind James Wiseman, who should be the MVP for Team Ramsey.
Mr. Clark.
Final score 190 here in the first ever, the inaugural Slam Summer Classic.
I think they put another 5 minutes on it.
Are they going to put another 5 minutes? No. Yeah.
Fans, you know, couldn't get enough, and of course they couldn't get enough of me and you.
Come on.
So they go right back in for another 5 minutes and just let the guys, I guess, like a
They're not going to put another 5 minutes.
Yeah, that's what Dennis was saying. I think it's like a miniature, you see it? Like a miniature dunk contest?
Oh, maybe.
Hey, the fans had a good time, man. They engaged today, man. They came out and did what we asked. Which
well,
is
in the
support.
Actual regulation
see
game.
That for a second.
Oh, God.
Now, we ain't going to do another five, ref. We ain't going to do another five. Ref,
I think that might just be a clock error right there, five? G.
I was just impressed, man. I mean, I
just. Let's go there. We do it. I'm working with the players. They deserve it.
I'm just so happy for New York City.
Oh, they're actually going to do another 5 minutes. Well, you know what? Listen, when it comes to street ball and legends, this is how legends are made, right, G?
I'm impressed. Like I said, I can always
so
tell my kids.
Does that mean they start at zero now for the 5 minutes?
Since we all came out
we are
so
really,
early,
we are really freestyling right here in the park. We are doing it in the park. Uncle G Stacks on Bobby C.
Doing it in the park. Boy.
Doing it in the park.
Hold on 1 second, ref. But y'all got to give me five serious. Y'all have fun for the whole game. We need 5 serious minutes.
My iPhone actually says that it needs to cool down before you can use it again.
Are you serious?
My big sister for coming out.
Yeah, I mean, that's...
That's the 10?
Taking like 18 years to make it outside, but she out here.
Well, you know, to our producers there, don't text me because I'm not going to get it.
Oh, God.
I think even our... We got like a tablet here, folks, honey, that lets us know what you guys are chiming in on the Facebook, and that
White
that's
got
even,
six. Won't we get five
that's
and five?
Even been melted here, I think, here.
Burnt out.
In the second half. 5 minutes of serious.
Burnt out.
Give us 5 minutes of serious, and we got to have fun at the same time. Simple. Right side, what time would it go now?
Birthday. I think we can, you know, we can improvise.
We could.
It's Bobby C. It's Uncle G.
Thank everybody, the parents, for flying in this week.
All right, folks. Well, we are back with another 5 minutes. This is kind of unprecedented. for the first ever Slam Summer Classic. An additional 5 minutes. We wiped the score away. In the last game, it was Team Ramsey with the victory. So we'll get Ramsey and Stanley back at it for another five.
So it's five for the hype.
Five for the hype is Rams TV from the free throw line. Zion Harmon.
We good.
Fires on the jump shot. That's Cash.
2018, boy.
Cassius, make sure Cassius Stanley's birthday, G.
That's why we're going to do what we do. We're going to look out for Cassius, man. Show him some East Coast love.
And now Rams TV to the bucket. It's a 3-2 game to start this minute and a half of action here at our quote-unquote overtime.
How you feeling today?
Jump shot from long range by Davis is off the mark. And here comes Zion Harmon, 3:20 to play here in the extra session.
Yeah.
Harmon with the dribble. And again, folks, if you're watching the stream, you can see all the people that are on the court right now, including Lance Stephenson, one of the newest Los Angeles Lakers.
Nobody need to get hurt.
Brooklyn's own.
Yeah.
Cassius, make sure you sub in with about a minute. Minute and a half.
And up the right side.
Hey, there they go. Jam. The legs is moving now.
So just a chance for the fans to kind of, you know, marinate, you know, and kind of bond and take some pictures and see your favorite
Christopher, by the way.
See your favorite guy. And the camera work out here has been unbelievable, man. Really has, man. I mean, shout out to the whole crew, but the camera work on this run. Wow.
You can go on forward. Trey.
Another jam here. Definitely want to give a shout out to L2 Productions, too,
G. You better. So many cameras.
Our main man, Scott. Right, mentioned him earlier.
Boy, Scott,
he's been with us for all seven of our live episodes.
Brought it to life.
So rough.
And Davis, off the glass.
Special shout out to our international audience, Bobby. How about
the international
audience that chimed in, man, and gave us the love.
Go to Cassius one time.
Turned us into kind of like viral sensations, you know, over seven games. So to the Facebook Live Nation, man, thank you.
Oh! Everybody clap it up for Cassius Stanley. Say happy
Cassius
birthday.
Stanley, happy birthday with that.
We're going to look out
with
for
that dunk, folks.
Yeah, bro, we calling it. We good. Players is good. We good.
And on this side, who do we have?
Appreciate it, everybody.
Well, it looks like Cassius Stanley has emerged as the MVP and James Wiseman.
Okay. That'll work.
Hey, yo, Dyckman.
So Cassius Stanley and James Wiseman are MVPs this afternoon.
Let's get a group picture. Everybody get a picture. Media, y'all can get your pictures.
Folks, thank you for tuning in with us. We'll have our MVP presentation coming up next. We'll also have Uncle G Stacks with our MVPs courtside. You're watching the first ever Slam Summer Classic live from Dyckman Park here on the stream. I'm the voice, Bobby C. Uncle G Stacks again coming right back at you just a moment. Oh, and apparently now, because again, our prompter went out here, but it looks like Jalen Green from Team Stanley, Stanley won the MVP voting.
Don't play
along
no
with James
with
Wiseman.
Pitches, please.
Wiseman and Green, the MVP stars of the afternoon. And again, we'll have Uncle G Stacks coming up next right here in the post game with our MVPs.
You take care of West Coast players for sure. Give one more. Two people in here. Held the yacht down for them last night. They was in party mode all night. He definitely held their yacht down for them. Slam edition. MVP. Jalen Green, Wiseman, come on. Yeah, they can come together. 12, no, you'll find out. Look like a 12. James, come here, James. I'll go to him.
James Wiseman.
Whoa.
Okay.
MVP, baby.
2018 Slam Showdown. I'm here with the MVP, Mr. Wiseman. And as you can see, the commemorative sneakers, a fantastic job, Yo Ching. You know, uplifting the young man today, coming out here, really capturing the imagination of the crowd. Talk a little bit about what it's like
coming out here, not only the sneakers, but being the best player amongst the best kids.
I mean, really, it's a humbling experience, but I mean, this atmosphere is crazy, and I just went out here and just played hard and just showed what I could do.
Showed a lot of hops, man. You got a lot of highlights. You was able to capture the imagination of a lot of fans. Talk about what it was like having the crowd behind you first time they saw you.
I mean, it was crazy. Like, once the crowd started screaming, then, like, I mean...
Again, folks, just moments away from having Uncle G Stacks courtside with our MVPs. And again, just to clarify, it is Jalen Green. He was leading the votes.
I want to get to Ching. And, you know, you not only the voice of Dyckman, the voice of these kids. What was it like for you today uplifting them and just taking them to that level where they were really, really ready to come out here and play for this MVP money?
It was just simple. You know, I just wanted to bring that life I bring every night out here in the park. They from the West Coast. You know, Kentucky and all those areas. So I was able to bring that Dyckman feel. So when they go back home, they come back to the city and they know it's in operate mode.
Great job. So for Slam Magazine and Mr. Wiseman, what we want to know, we're going to follow you. You know, you're a viral sensation. But what we want to know here at Dyckman is, if you're in town, if you're around the park, can we look for you to come back, man, and show off again?
Yes, sir. I got you.
Okay, so for Uncle G Stacks, for the MVP, Mr. Wiseman, for Cha-Ching, for the Dyckman faithful, thanks for hanging out, man. Hey, 2018 post-game interview with Jalen Green, the other MVP. And Jalen, I'm going to tell you, I not only became a fan today, and of course Ching, but New York City was impressed with you. So talk a little bit about your preparation, about you coming out here and capturing the epic center of what it is for kids. How'd it feel?
Yeah, I'm just working hard every day, you know, getting in the gym when I can, you know, when no one's watching. So to come out here, it's a good experience, a humbling experience. You know, coming to Dyckman, the atmosphere is different. I'm from Cali, so, you know, they be saying, like, I can't hold my own here. And I for sure come back playing a real Dyckman game, so. So it's a good experience. I love you.
You did good today. I mean, you came, you brought the West Coast flavor. You played in front of probably the hottest MC you'll ever see. So what was it like finally? I saw you engaged a little bit with other players. Did that lift you up at any point? You know, that back and forth that Dyckman is so famous for?
Yeah, that one-on-one right there got me hyped. They got me locked in. So that was fun. You know, you really can't do that in AAU. You got that help side, everything. So just getting to go at somebody that's top of the class, you know, it's a good.
And Ching, how do you, I don't know how you do it. We talk about the dancing shoes, which you've made famous up here. How do you get these kids to suit up and go right into their dancing shoes and then still come away with a good performance and the victory?
I mean, all their friends talk about it through Facebook, through social media. So I just wanted to make sure that they come to bring their A game. You know, I missed them yesterday at the dunk. He was dunking off and all that other stuff. I missed them yesterday, so I wanted to make up for it today. You know what I mean? So he came out and balled out, man. So we did it the Dyckman way, the West Coast way, the Ching Ching way. You know how it go.
So we're going to send you back. We're going to send you back to the West Coast with this East Coast love. Dyckman loves you, man. And when you're in town, when you find out that there's a game, will you come back and give us another dose?
Of course. I'm going to pull up every time. It's good.
Okay, you heard it here, man, from Dyckman, for Cha-Ching, for Uncle G Stacks, and for today's MVP from the left coast, man. Y'all have a good day.
All right, folks, there you have it again. We mentioned it before. You have our two MVPs as we close out our first ever Slam Summer Classic. A great job by Uncle G Stacks. What a performance today by both of these teams, Team Ramsey and Team Stanley. Just wanted to thank everyone that made this day possible. Again, from Facebook and Slam, as we close this one out, for my partner in crime, Uncle G Stacks. Again, I'm the voice, Bobby C. Congratulations to our MVPs, and congratulations to all 20 of the top high school players in the country playing in the first ever Slam Summer Classic. Thanks for tuning in. We will see you next year. We'll be right back.
Thank you.